Sir, before I get to the content of the bill, just two observations on the way we are still doing legislation. There was a tradition here in Parliament, if 10 bills were passed, one was an ordinance. That was the score in the first 30 years of our country. The second 30 years of our country, the new score, out of every 10 bills passed, about 2 were an ordinance. But sir, in the last 3 or 4 years, out of every 10 bills passed, 4 are an ordinance. Sir, this quick fix ordinance is not good. It's not a good solution. So through you, sir, I appeal to this government that don't keep using this ordinance route. Otherwise, you know, you keep crying wolf, 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 you want to pass everything like that. The first one. And second point, sir, is on the scrutiny of the bills. You know, it's not enough to say that this bill is changing or adding only one word. So it's a simple bill, so we don't need to scrutinize it. We used to scrutinize bills, sir, earlier parliaments. The average in the first 60 years, 65 years, was about 70 to 72%. Last 5 years, sir, scrutiny of bills by parliamentary committees is down to 25%. Sir, you are the custodian of this house. You must help us to protect this, sir. As it is, the standing committees which came in 1993, as it is, they are semi-toothless, because unlike many established conventions in other countries, here, for whatever reason, we don't allow ministers to be asked questions on standing committees. The bureaucrats have to come. I'm not now suggesting the ministers should start coming, but at least let's take the standing committee seriously. And the logic of saying it's a one-line bill, it's a one word, in that case, India, that is Bharat, is a union of states. You change one word there, India, that is Bharat, is not a union of states. Put one three-letter word there, but the context change. So I don't want us to be discussing the content of the bill as to the words. Let's come to this bill itself, sir. Firstly, I want to use this opportunity to wish the former leader of the House, Mr. Arun Jaitley, a quick recovery, because it was he who piloted this bill as Commerce Minister and Vajpayee ji was in charge. The Trinamool Congress has had a very clear view on this, that we are opposed to the policy of SEZ. Now, sir, it's always been in our manifesto, and Mamta ji has fought for this for many, many years. So anyway, let me, on the history, so Arun Jaitley ji brought it, and one of the reasons to bring it, of course, to compete with China, there were infrastructure issues, power, the current minister is also the power minister, now he says there's no power, the power is supplies free, surplus. These were the original reasons to bring the bill, because these SEZs, that was not the argument which we bought into, but you know, you need infrastructure, you need power surplus. So in that first SEZ, which was in Mumbai, the number of jobs that generated was not even one job, not even one job. After it was nothing but a flop show. Then you came into the Dr. Manmohan Singh government, and then what happened then? From a flop show, 3 years later, it became a land scam show. Land was being acquired left, right and center. Trinamool Congress said this in its manifesto. We repeatedly expressed our serious apprehensions and disagreement on SEZ. Our voices were not heard, and the mistake on this continues to be made. Today, most people agree that SEZs have failed the nation. They've become a tool in the hands of a few vested interests and the land mafia. That's the Trinamool manifesto. I'm going to read 3 lines from another manifesto. So this is the history of NDA, then UPA. Now another manifesto from 2009. The country needs to know this, sir. This is the manifesto, and I quote, "The UPA government has approved 572 super economic zones that cover, special economic zones that cover 50,000 acres, 3 times the size of Singapore. This is absurd. This spells disaster for the farm sector. We will not allow the conversion of fertile farmland for industrial commercial projects or special economic zones." Such a disaster, sir. 2009, This was the BJP manifesto of 2009. So what they say depends on where they sit. 2009 BJP manifesto. So I mean, I'll speak in Bengali a little, sir. Okay. Age jomi oti grohon. Shobche egiye ei jomi oti grohon andolone Mamata Banerjee. Apnara shobai janen Nandigram, Singur, koto jomi andolon hoyeche. 2006 sale 26 diner onoshon Mamata ji koreche. কেন করেছে? যে কৃষি জমি কেউ চিন্তায় নিয়ে নিতে পারবে না, এইটাই হলো কনসেপ্ট। তারপরে কি হয়েছে? সিঙ্গুর ল্যান্ড রিহ্যাবিলিটেশন বিল পাস হয়েছে ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল অ্যাসেম্বলিতে। অনেক অল দিস হ্যাজ হ্যাপেন্ড স্যার। ফাইনালি সুপ্রিম কোর্ট অফ ইন্ডিয়া টার্ম দ্য ল্যান্ড অ্যাকুইজিশন এগ্রিমেন্ট অ্যাকুইজিশন ইন সিঙ্গুর ইলিগাল and unconstitutional. Sir, this is one party in India, one leader in India who has had a consistent stand from the time we started our party in 1998 to now, that you cannot acquire land. For which you might say, why are you so anti-industry? Sir, we are not anti-industry. Our belief is industry, agriculture, they can coexist, sir. And that has been the basis of the policies. Special economic zones haven't worked. Even if you look at the job numbers, besides all these land scams, in answer to a colleague of mine, Shukhendu Shekhar Roy's question in the Rajya Sabha, the numbers were given of these special economic zones and the jobs lost. Here we go. If you look at, I'm not going into the details of the job loss, but the few jobs which were generated, because the basic of the special economic zone's bottom line was to generate jobs. And if you look at the numbers, even get worse after demonetization. At least it was 2 lakh, 1 lakh before that. Those numbers have since dropped. So now let's come to some of the Sir, the non-functioning SEZs also, the number, sir, is available. There are so many CAG reports also which are all available. All in the public domain, that the SEZs haven't worked. Sir, the trust. Trust means who? I don't want to play on the words, because my colleague from the Congress party has done a great job on the words. But sir, serious issues. Are these also religious trusts? Which company today, which large corporation today runs on a trust? Nobody is on trust. They are publicly, they are LLB companies, etc. Now, when you say trust, the only big brand I know, at least in my limited knowledge of trust, pata nahi if there's any others, but Patanjali is a trust. I mean, one example, I'm sure all of you will come up with different examples. What is this trust? Are we now talking about religious trust? Because big corporations don't need trust. Please. Sir, two more points before please, I conclude.
Please,
sir.
Please, you have to conclude.
Thank you, sir. Sir, in February, in Jharkhand, since Jharkhand is now conveniently in the news, I mean sadly in the news sometimes, and we get some responses sometimes, the first standalone power project in India, SEZ, was to Adani. Project will save the company 3.2 billion annually. Why was it chosen? What is the criteria? That, sir, we need to look into. I want to conclude now, sir. I want to conclude, because this is not only an SEZ issue. This is a land issue. This is that. That's the core of this issue. Rabindranath likhechen. Shudu bighe dui chilo mor. Bhui ar shobi gache rine. বাবু বলিলেন বুঝেছে উপেন এ জমি লইবে কিনে লইব কিনে। থ্যাংক ইউ প্রদীপ দা। কহিলাম আমি তুমি ভূস্বামী ভূমির অন্ত নাই চেহে দেখো মোর আছে বড় জোর মরিয়া মতঠাই।
থ্যাংক ইউ
স্যার। ইটস ইম্পর্টেন্ট স্যার, দিস ইজ দি division of the class struggle written by Rabindranath. Even if we hadn't read this poem, sir, in 1953, the basic concept is, sir, the basic concept, he described the class divide and the forceful land grabbing by a zamindar from a poor peasant in
Thank
a poem
you.
And Bimal Roy, another great Bengali, Do Biga Zameen, sir, in 1953. He made this film and this is the story. Sir, this is not the kind of legislation. This is opaque, and the Trinamool Congress, even if we are the only people standing here, will oppose SEZ.
Thank you.
We will oppose SEZ.
Thank you,
sir.